Hello friends, today we'll see how a basic pricing procedure is configured and what are different components of that. So basically, what is a pricing procedure? First, what I'll do, I'll create one purchase order ME21N, and when I enter the vendor and other details in PO, say material is A238, quantity 10. So you will see that the gross price has been taken from the info record, plus if I add some discount here, RA01, say 5%. So this discount, even though I added at the last of this list, but it has been moved up, and on that 10 euro, 5% discount is calculated and net landed cost is calculated, 9.5. So this calculation structure is called as the pricing procedure, and we'll see how that is configured. This pricing procedure is configured in transaction SPRO, which is the customizing transaction SPRO. Okay, click on this SAP reference IMG, and in that select materials management. Click on purchasing, and in that conditions, define price determination process. Okay, so for the pricing procedure, as we have seen, the condition table is the basis for this, or that is the foundation. To store the condition records, we need to have the condition tables. Usually in most of the deployments, we use the standard settings and we need not create any condition table or access sequence. But for your understanding, I will explain that concept, how a condition table is created. So I click on this transaction, maintain condition table. Here we have three options: create, change, display. So what I'll do, first I will display this table, and 017 or 17 number table, this is for info record, material info record. This is with validity period, means the condition records will have validity from and to date. Okay, and this is the key combination. So on left side you will see the key fields of this table: vendor, material, purchasing organization, plant and info record category. Now this 017 table, it will have a database table A017. Okay, so actual database table which stores these conditions is A017. Now if we want to create our own condition table, then I double click here, create condition table. The convention here is from 1 to 500, these numbers are reserved by SAP. We cannot create in that range, and our range is from 501 to 999. So that is the customer range. We can create condition tables in that range. So now I will create, say, one table 685. This is one table which I want to create. Okay, now for this table, say my key combination is material and plant. So I want to store condition records or the prices for that key combination, and on right side this is the list of field catalog, and we can select fields from this. So it is not on the first page. I'll click on page down. So here it is material. Double click on the material and it will be selected on the left side. So this will be the key field of this table. Then I have plant. Double click here. So I create table 685 with two field combination, material and plant. Now here you will see that with validity period, it means this condition record will have a from to validity dates. With release status, so usually we don't use this, like the condition is released and available for use. So I click on this button, that is generate. There is warning message, table 142 already defined with the same fields. So this is standard SAP table defined with the same key combination, but this is warning message, we can override and proceed. So I'll press enter or click on continue. Now there is message, do you want to generate table? Yes. We'll save this as a local object. Okay, so 805 table A685 has been created. So this is the database table which is generated, and we can see the table structure in transaction SE11. So if I go to transaction SE11, and here if I select this table A685 which I just now created and click on display, now the conditions in this table, these are stored like these are the few standard fields like client, application, condition type, and these are the key combination which I have selected, material number and plant. And since it was with validity periods, so there is validity start and end date, and finally it will have one condition record number. Okay, so this is how SAP stores the condition values. I will explain you with this example. So if I see the info record, material is A238. Okay, this is one info record, and I'll go to display mode, info record display. Vendor 100, material A238, purchasing organization 1000, plant 1000, info category standard, and enter. So here you will see the rate maintenance 10 euro per piece or per number. So how SAP stores this condition record? We have seen that the info record table was 017. I'll create another session here, and through transaction SE16N or SE16. SE16N is for ECC6, earlier versions it is SE16. So in SE16 we can actually see the table entries. Okay, so press enter. Now this is SE16 transaction, and the info record table is A017. Now in SE16, if I give this for this A017, I'll give this key combination which was there in the info record. Info type was standard, so I'll select standard here and click on number of entries. So there is one entry existing with this record. Execute. Okay, so this is that specific entry, and your actual price of 10 euro per piece is not stored in this table, but it will have only one condition record number. Okay, and this with this condition record number we will go to table KONP or KONV, and there it will store the actual condition. So I copy this number by right click here and create another session. Again AC16, and I go to table KONP, and this is the condition record number. I'll paste it here and check the number of entries. So there is one entry found. Execute. Okay, so here you can see that the price is amount is 10 euro per piece, which is the price maintained in the info record. If you see this info record, 10 euro per piece is the price. How it is stored? In table A017, the key combination is stored. PB00 is the condition, vendor, material, purchasing organization, plant, and finally one field is that condition record number. And with this condition record number, the actual value is stored in table KONP. And here you will see that the price has been stored. So this is SAP logic of storing the condition, price conditions. Similarly, what table just now we have created, that is 685, again it has the last field condition record number, and the value in this table will be stored in that KONP table. Okay. Now the earlier key combination that I selected is material and plant. Now I want to select another key combination, material, plant and vendor. So I'll create two different condition tables. Okay, the key combinations are different. So 685 I have created, I will create another table 686. table I want to create, continue, and here you select the key combination material, plant and I want vendor, so again page down vendor. So with this key combination again I select with validity periods and generate this table. So warning message is table 580 already have the same combination. Press enter. Do you want to create? Yes. Save it as a local object. Okay, so now this 686 has been created. Okay. Again, if you see the this table structure 686 display. So now here you have the key combination material, plant and vendor, and again this validity period from to date and condition record number. It will have only number and actual value will be stored in table KONP. Okay. So this covers the table. Condition tables, that technique. Then the next thing is access sequence. Okay, so here I have created two condition tables. The key combination was for one it is material plus plant, and for other it is material plus plant plus vendor. So when in purchase order, if I want to search the price for a particular condition, my first preference will be first look out for the most specific table, that is 686, which is material, plant, vendor. If there is no condition record found in that, then go to the next table 685, which is more general, that is material plus plant. And this kind of sequence or the search strategy for condition record in condition tables is called as the access sequence, and this is that step, define access sequence. Okay. So I'll go to this define access sequence. Okay. Now here I will create my new access sequence. So click on new entries. Say this is your access sequence. So it is ZT03, ZTest03. And I'll say test access sequence 03. Enter. Now this is the access sequence name, and I want to assign the tables to this, which tables it has to search and in what sequence. So select this line and double click on accesses, click on new entries. Now this is the step number and this is the table number. Okay, so steps usually we give some space like 5, 10, 15, 20, so that in future if you have to add any step in between, say after 5 you want to add some step in future, so you have space like 6, 7, 8. If you take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then it will not be possible to add that step in future. Okay, so we give some space. So I'll say the first step is 5, second is 10, and first I want to search in the most specific table 686. If the condition record is not there, then more general table 685. Okay, some information message, continue. Okay, now we have to map the fields. The key field mapping is to be done. Okay, so select this line, fields, some warning message, enter. Enter. And for the table 686, the key combination is material, plant, vendor. So that is mapped. Again, for the another table, key combination is material and plant, and then we save this. So this is a transport request generated. Click on continue. Save this.